I'm about to sail up. Today we're going to cover mid-size electric motors. That's something around the 20 kilowatt mark, anyway from 15 up to 25, 30. It seems to be quite a need for huge motors these days, and electric is obviously the way that the market is running. So we're going to check it out, and we're going to start right away with Igor from Edyne with this, which really looks like it belongs on Batman's boat.
Yes, it's really Batman boats. And this is 25 kilowatt.
Yeah.
It's water-cooled system, open system, like a Honda and Yamaha. And you have the aluminum shaft. It's very light. So, and you have the electric trim here. You can trim it like the normal engine.
Okay.
And 12-inch propeller.
Right. Okay. So just to rewind and slow that down, there's a lot of information. This is water-cooled. So have you it's got an impeller in there that we need to maintain as per?
No, it's not impeller. We have the water pump there.
Ah.
Because the cooling is the motor and cooling is the converter.
Yeah.
And the pump is electric pump, and this pump push the water from here up to here and out.
All right, cool. That's pretty smart.
Yeah.
And how do we maintain that?
The maintenance is nothing. Generally, it's only the oil. We have only oil here, and that is possibly in 1 year to change. Another, you don't need the maintenance.
Okay.
It's okay.
That's quite cool. And like you say, we've got trim adjustment here. This is electronic.
Electric trim, yes. So by the throttle, the pushing, and you can trim it electric.
Right. Okay. And the weight of this model?
45 kilos.
45 kilos.
It's very light because it's aluminium. But then you buy the battery is 100 kilos.
Yeah.
And then complete system is approximately 160 kilos because you need the cables, you need the distribution box display.
And what kind of range would you expect to get for a straightforward system like that?
It's different for the battery pack. And generally, we put a 15 kilowatts hour battery pack. That is for 40 minutes by full speed.
Right.
But when you drive slowly with 1 kilowatt consumption, you can drive 15 hours.
All right. Wow. Yeah. That's quite cool. Well, it's definitely the swishiest looking motor on the market, I would say anyway. Absolutely fantastic. And let's see what else we've got to see as well. Thank you very much, Igor.
Thank you very much. Thank you.
Thank you, Zan. Okay, next up, we've got Elco with M Motors. This is Yogi. Hi, mate.
Hey.
Yogi's just been telling me you've been in business for absolutely years, and this thing just looks like a normal outboard. So how long have you been going?
We started in 1893, back in America with the Chicago Boat Show, a World Trade Show. About 15 years ago, we started building the outboards, the electric outboards,
yeah.
And we decided to just, you know, put it on the classic frame. It's true, it's tested, people know what it's look like, they're comfortable with it.
Yeah, yeah. And I actually quite like the fact that you don't need to worry about it getting stolen as much.
Yeah.
I think that's quite important. With
right, but it also, it doesn't look like some alien thing hanging off the back of your boat.
This is true.
You know, where everybody's like, what is that? Because the first time I saw some of the other motors or competitors, I didn't get it. I didn't know what was going on, you know?
Yeah, yeah, yeah.
But so we took, it has the gear loop in it, just like a regular outboard.
Yeah.
There's an impeller, goes up, and we just changed this out to be our, you know, this is a proprietary motor. We have it built for us.
So it's water cooled, is it?
Yeah.
All right, cool. Okay.
Yeah, so the impeller kicks it up there, and, you know, so the dealers have things they can work on. Customers come back to talk to the dealers later to get, you know, service and updates and things like that.
Yeah, yeah.
But it's a very, very good motor.
And this one is a 20 kilowatt motor that we're looking at right now.
20 horsepower equivalent.
20 horsepower equivalent. And what sizes do these go up to?
Outboards, we go up to 50 horse.
Right.
And the inboards, we go up to 200.
Okay. And you just attach this to what systems?
The same systems they work on the other ones. If you're repowering your boat,
right,
all those other systems will work except for the batteries and gas tank, of course. But you can put your steering on here, the trim and tilt system that you have.
So it's basically a retrofit electric system.
It fits on just like every other outboard. So if your electric or your gas outboard died and you're hanging a new one, you just take all the steering controls and the power control off.
Yeah.
We do have a remote throttle for this. You do need to use our proprietary one. But mounts in the same way. We have a top mount, side mount, whatever you need.
Happy days. And now, batteries wise, with a lot of companies, they're making you use their own batteries. How does this work here?
Well, we like to say that we are battery agnostic.
All right.
Right? Because you can use lead acid, you can use AGM, you can use lithium iron phosphate,
right,
whatever. They work with our motors as long as you have enough voltage and enough amp hours to do what you want to do. You can buy your own. You don't have to buy ours. So that, I mean, when you're talking about electric motors, the expensive part of the equation is the batteries.
Yeah, it is.
So giving our customers that flexibility that, you know, we don't have to ship batteries to the Netherlands from America, they can just buy them here. That saves a lot of money for our international customers. Right. It keeps it very simple. And then, you know, every boat's a little bit different. There's no blanket answer to what's going to work for your boat, right?
There you go.
So why would I tell you you have to use this battery, right? I'm just happy you got our motor.
Happy days. So we take this unit now, which is the 20 horsepower equivalent. What's the weight of this?
About 70 pounds, 70, 80 pounds, somewhere in there.
Okay.
It's really very equivalent, a little bit lighter than a combustion engine would be,
yeah.
But very similar in weight.
Yeah, yeah. Warranty-wise, what do you get?
It's 3 years parts and service.
Well, there we go. That's Elco, a brand built on heritage and classic looks, I think.
Thank you so much.
Thank you very much. Cheers, Yogi.
Yeah.
So next up, we've got no stranger to the electric market whatsoever, and that's e-propulsion. They've just smashed out this new stuff onto the market, which is kind of changing everything, I reckon. This is Ricky. He's going to tell us a bit about it. Good to see you, Ricky, mate. How are you?
Very good. How are you?
I'm all right. So you guys have recently won a Dame Award, which for those of you who don't know, it's a very prestigious award within the industry. Tell me about it.
Right. So, the first time e-propulsion won a Dame Award was actually 9 years ago now.
Right,
for
okay.
An old Navy six motor. So, that's something that we wanted to continue doing.
Yeah.
Continue with our technology, continue with good new products. We put a lot of R&D into this. So some of the really unique functions is the electronic steering, the electronic trim, and that's all built into this. There's no need for cables or hydraulics going on. It will automatically trim the boat as well.
Quite amazing now. I mean, that's like literally a plug and play situation where you just stick it on the back of your boat, plug your electric steering wheel in that comes with it. Is that right?
It comes with it, yeah.
And that's you?
Yep.
Trims, angles, everything adjusted.
Yeah, so everything is there, every little element you need to convert your boat to electric.
Okay. Yep. And what sizes are these available in?
Right, so we're doing the little one over here is a 12 kilowatt motor, and then a 20 and a 40.
Which is pretty
hefty. That's quite a big range. So that's replacements for combustion engines up to 60, 70 horsepower.
Okay, cool. And these are 96 volt, is that correct?
This is a 96 volt system. It's on the same architecture as our I-Series, which we launched at the show last year.
That's right.
So we're using the same battery, and the same system architecture.
Okay, cool. So weight wise on this one, this is the mid range. This is the X20. How much does this one weigh in it?
This one's in at 73 kilos. So it's a fair lump. You're not going to run a marathon with it.
And how about if we just talk quickly on price as well? Because I think we all know, obviously, this size of motor, the batteries are not attached to it.
Yep.
They're separate. We need to know what it's going to cost and where that is within the market, basically.
Right. So the actual prices haven't been confirmed yet, but the rough price guide is 10, 13, and 16,000 euros, inclusive of taxes.
Okay.
How does that sit in the market?
That's pretty low.
If we were looking at the X40, for example, the other 40 kilowatt outboards on the market are roughly 2 to 3 times more expensive.
So like you've really managed to bring that down. I think it's cool.
So that's been a big part of the R&D's project is to keep the cost down as low as possible whilst keeping the quality as high as possible.
Good luck. Another thing we've got to talk about quickly as well is battery sizes. What do you offer?
Right, what do we offer? So
the autonomy on them as well.
We offer a standard range of batteries at e-propulsion. This range, it will be our G-Series battery.
Yep.
We'd recommend a minimum of one battery for the little one, two for the middle one, and four for the big one. What is that going to do for you on the X20 here? So that's going to give you autonomy for 6 to 8 hours at half speed, depending on the vessel and the conditions, but that's a very reasonable estimate.
I think that's quite good.
Yeah.
Okay, well, there you go. E-propulsion, I've done it again. Cheers, Ricky. Thanks, mate.
Nice to meet you.
All right. And this is the Parsun Joy 6. It's a 6-kilowatt motor, and she's a 48-volt motor. And I think, motors and motors, they're getting bigger nowadays. Again, she's lithium-powered. This one has no battery inside of it. It's all externally powered. So she weighs in at, I think, around 34 kilos, which makes it relatively lightweight. I'm just going to check that size there, that weight now. Yeah, she's 34 kilos, and it's capable of powering a boat which is anywhere from 5 to 7 meters is the intention for this. This battery bank that it comes with, which is the one they recommend to pair with it, gives you an hour and a half at full throttle, and it gives you 3 hours of range at half throttle. If you slow down beyond that, apparently you get a lot longer out of it. But all in all, it's quite a neat system. It's quite easy to use. It's basically like any other outboard you've seen. It all angles on here so you can get your trim positions correct. Interchangeable props so you can have more thrust if you need that. But quite a lightweight system in all honesty, and quite simple. Usual connections on here, all watertight, IP67, as you'd expect. So that's it from Parsun, and hopefully we'll see what else they've got coming up soon. I can't really say too much, but let's just say they've got something else in the pipeline that we're looking forward to testing. We'll see you next time, guys.